1927 was an important year for Kennywood. Kittyland was moved from its spot across from the Jackrabbit to its current location. The tumblebug, now called the turtle, first began making its rounds. The racer completed the park's trio of Golden Age winning coasters. And the park added its crown jewel, a 1926 Dentzel merry-go-round that still spins at the park today. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the history of the Kennywood Carousel over its 90-plus years at the park. The park's 1927 Dentzel Carousel is actually one of the last ever built by the Dentzel family. Given that it's a later era carousel, it makes sense that there were two other carousels before the current one at Kennywood. They are both housed in this building, constructed with the park in 1899, making it the oldest building in Kennywood. The Parkside Cafe was actually built in 1900. The carousel that opened with the park in 1899 was also carved by Dentzel. In 1913, the park slightly enlarged this building to add its second merry-go-round, a ride built by the T.M. Harding Company with many figures carved by Daniel Mueller. In 1927, the park struck a great deal to buy this carousel for the price of $25,000. It was originally built for the 1926 Philadelphia Sesquicentennial Exposition, however, it was not finished in time, as this was in the last years of the Dentzel Company. The park soon found that its old carousel building was not large enough to fit the new ride, so constructed this new building for the price of $10,000. The park also earned the trade-in price of $3,500 for the old T.M. Harding Company carousel. So all in all, it was a great deal for Kennywood. Shipped to Pittsburgh from Philadelphia on the Pennsylvania Railroad, William Dentzel was still able to make the trip to oversee the installation of the ride, despite his failing health. One of four Dentzel carousels in Pennsylvania, the ride also features the oldest known Wurlitzer 153 band organ that actually operated on the park's previous carousel as well as this one. Two important milestones in the ride's history occurred in 1976 and 2005, when the ride was completely repainted. In 2005, upgraded mechanics were also installed, along with a new control system. For decades, Tony Sacramento was the face of the Kennywood Carousel, being its operator for many summers until his death in 1998. This horse is the lead figure on the carousel, known as Pegasus, also sometimes nicknamed by Tony as Death. Horses on either side of Pegasus are the only horses on the carousel that have bedrolls on their saddles. This led to the urban legend being created that these horses represent the horses of General Grant and General Lee. Often overlooked, the carousel is definitely the soul of Kennywood. Thanks for watching.